Let's get you in the loop on the new ATEM Television Studio 4K 8 from Blackmagic Design. This new desktop panel from Blackmagic is the 4K iteration of the Television Studio HD 8 and HD 8 ISO released earlier this year and something I've looked at here on the channel. Released at NAB 2023, this ATEM includes 8 12G SDI inputs and 10 12G SDI outputs. It can run at up to 2160p 60 for high quality Ultra HD productions and includes 4K streaming and recording all in this one device. All the 8 inputs have scalers built in, meaning you can connect all sorts of SDI inputs up to it at varying resolutions and it will be scaled up to Ultra HD or whatever standard you have the mixer set to. Just like the HD version, the 4K 8 will allow for control of a big portion of its feature set right from the top panel. That includes program preview switching, camera and audio control, auxiliary control, streaming, and recording start and stop. On the back, you'll see all the connections, inputs, outputs, program output, multi-view as well, and a 10G network switch as well. This 10G switch is an upgrade over the HD version. In fact, with all that 4K footage on the internal storage, you'll want some way of getting it off and getting it off fast. Unlike the HD model here, this 4K 8 has 10 aux outputs, meaning you can route all of your video inputs back out again to monitors and other destinations. There's not currently or may never be an ISO version of this 4K switcher. In fact, Blackmagic Design have said that that's why they've made 10 aux outputs here. They've said that for cost and cooling reasons, the fully ISO model of this 4K 8 is just not on the cards. So with all these outputs, you can route your feeds to local recorders and create your own ISO setup yourself. They've also added back in the 3-axis joystick on this 4K model. Not entirely sure why that wasn't included in the HD version, but maybe it was a costing thing. So now you can use this again to move your SuperSource and DVE boxes around. I found in the past that I end up just bumping this thing by accident and I never really use it during productions anyway. It is interesting to note though that there seems to be more audio routing options out of the aux outputs. It looks like you can't choose the audio output on each of your auxes, but rather a global SDI output setting where you decide what is on each of the audio channels. The 4K 8 is due for release in the next few months at around $4,600 US, and it's likely to be a nice choice for those waiting to head into the 4K world of recording and streaming, all while getting a feature-packed switcher and a control unit all in one. And if 8 inputs are not enough for you, Blackmagic did just announce the 4ME Constellation 4K as well, so that's a bit of a step up from this one, but it'll allow you to do a lot more inputs, a lot more outputs. All right, let me know if you have any questions about this in the comments below. Otherwise, consider yourself in the loop on the ATEM Television Studio 4K 8.